We're talking about these things in the middle of one of the scariest times, and I don't quite know how to have these conversations now when my mind is just on this pandemic. It really is. But I appreciate everybody's, and I don't have an argument in this matter, and I don't have a dog in this race, but I like utilizing all of our assets. Vice Mayor Pro Tem.
Well, I wasn't first, but I'll go ahead, Madam Mayor.
I think we've
heard over and over again when this issue's been brought up that there are just a lot of obstacles to make this reality for a very, very little return on investment. So I'd like to just go ahead and call the question and call the vote here, and let's move on.
I'd like to add a few things.
The question's been called, unfortunately, and that's the way.
I'm sorry.
I'm sorry. Point of parliamentary inquiry.
Christine?
In order to call the question, you need a motion and a second and a vote. The Christine. Commissioner's motion did not have a second. We haven't taken
a
vote.
I haven't asked for a second yet. I was trying to, everyone was yelling out. Someone asked to call the question, so that's a motion. Do I have a second?
Second.
Do I have a second? So I have a first and a second, which means now all those in favor state so by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Aye. All those opposed? Motion carries.
Excuse me, nay. Nay.
I would like to comment on the motion.
That's
permissible. Minute.
At least deliberation is over. No, it's not. We're moving on to the next item.
This is a do-nothing, absolutely do-nothing group.
That's not how
$100,000 on a study for parks.
Christy.
Point of information.
I'm speaking with the city attorney right now to clarify.
Yes, thank you, Madam Mayor. So the correct procedure is when the question is called is to obtain a vote on it. Now, under Robert's Rules of Order, that has to be a supermajority. So technically, it would have to be a 4-1, otherwise the vote fails. So what I just heard was a 3-2 on the issue to call the question.
Okay.
So the motion would fail to call the question, but also please keep in mind, you know, under Robert's Rules of Order, technically everybody should get two bites at the apple. And after two bites at the apple, unless there's a motion made to extend debate and allow further bites at the apple, the debate is supposed to come to a close.
I know, and that's the issue that I have that I keep running into. And everyone wants 16 bites at the apple, and they want to take 20 minutes to make their point when somebody else takes 2 minutes, and it's not fair all around. And I'm trying to be fair, and I'm not trying to limit conversation, but we also have these things in place so we can get business done. And really? It's the same people that keep changing the whole policy. We've been doing these meetings for a long period of time, and we've never had issue with it until recently. And I'm confused because what happens is if I play it by the rules, right? If I play it by the rules and everyone gets mad, right? So then I give more. I give more opportunity and I open it up, and then I get called out for I didn't follow the rules that I said to begin with. That's what I was told several times. I didn't follow the rules that I was set to begin with. So you have to decide, do you want me to do it by the rules, but then you have to play by the rules? Or do you want me to not do it by the rules and let you change the rules every time, or let you change the rules when you agree with it and not change the rules when you don't? You can't be that. And it's not fair to me. It really isn't, guys. I'm not trying to play hardball. I'm trying to be consistent here. And I can't keep changing the rules depending on how you feel every meeting. It's just not fair.
But we need to be able to respond to things that are part of the conversation. And when one person gets to say something that is just a tad off, off reality, and then isn't allowed to be responded to, it diminishes the decision. And, we're looking at, you talk about a master plan, you're gonna spend upwards to $100,000 to do a master plan, and you're gonna have the same question as to whether you're gonna, what you're gonna do with the docks. What I'm proposing is it's revenue neutral to the city to at least allow a proposal to manage it. What we're doing is laying the docks empty and allowing PBSO to be responsible when they don't need that much more to do. And it just boggles my mind that you won't even consider another opportunity to consider another method of use. The fine group said, of course, they're not going to do anything if we can't decide to do anything. So, you know, if you don't want to do anything, it's on you, not it's, you know, it's going to be an embarrassment to the city.
I do want to do something. And in fact,
then all you have to do is vote yes.
Hold on, excuse me. May I speak? Thank you. What I'm asking you is that I thought that this whole conversation, even though it was ending right now because we're not voting on anything in reference to it, I thought it was coming back at the next meeting. Isn't that what we decided? For it to come back at the next meeting with more facts?
No, Madam. So I made the motion. The motion is to postpone the item until the next regular meeting because the commissioner brought forward an item and he felt that when it was put on paper by staff that it did not reflect the communication that he gave to them. There was a discussion about other issues surrounding the item, but the motion is to postpone the issue until the next meeting to give Commissioner Robinson and staff the time to make sure that what's on paper and what is presented to us accurately reflects the endeavor that he embarked on.
That's now, exactly what I thought. So where's the problem?
Well, we haven't voted on that motion.
We were about to. He called the question and we were about to vote on that, and that's how it was laid out and that's how I thought it was. There is no controversy here. That's what I'm trying to say, guys. Why are we making controversy when we're going to bring it back?
So, you know, look, here's something that's true, okay? Calling the question on someone's item is controversial. Tabling someone's item, especially before they've been given a chance to discuss it, which has happened to items related to the dock before, that's also happened to me before, is controversial and it's not nice. It's like, you know,
me too.
Sure. Well, I haven't seen an item that you've brought forward, discussion on that item truncated by someone calling the question or by tabling it before.
I've had my ability to call a recess come into question when a recess is just taking a break, isn't it not?
But you know what I'm saying is I can't fault Commissioner Robinson for being upset because another commissioner is trying to call the question on his item before he feels that the discussion on it has been fulsome. Now, I get that there's this back and forth about the meaning of the rules. You know, I think just as a general rule, we should try to have a fulsome debate and try to really get to the bottom of these issues. I know it's been said that we're not here for discovery or deliberation. We're just here to do stuff. I would disagree with that. But that's, I think, a part of the issue here. Now, if Commissioner Robinson has something that he would like to express, the only thing I can say is I am interested in hearing it because it's his item. Other than that, I'm good, and I've made a motion to postpone to the next meeting.
And as I was saying, that a motion was made to postpone it to where he's going to present again, and he's going to give his options for these things, and we're going to have, I guess, further discussions with staff in reference to whatever, and I'll reach out to the people that I already spoke with. But again, we don't need to make a... You know, I understand that it's not nice when you don't have some, but that's what happens at meetings all the time, every week in thousands of cities and towns across the world. It's not personal. And, you know, let's get this done. You've already talked about it, even though you didn't want to talk about it tonight. We talked about it some, and we'll move on to the next time, guys. Come on. Is there anybody else that would still like to comment, or can we move on? I've got a motion on the floor in a second. Anyone want to speak before this? Raise your hand. All those in favor state so by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. All those opposed?
Nay.
So who was that? I said aye. Can we have a roll call? Aye.
Aye to postpone it to the next meeting?
Yes. Aye.
Madam Mayor, what
did you say, Commissioner Robinson?
Yes.
Yes. Okay. So motion carries 3-2.
Madam Mayor, may I?
We're moving on to our next item.
This issue has been brought up ad nauseum. Okay, it's not economically, you know, viable. It's not
revenue neutral.
It's not
point of order. Point of order.
Point of order, please.
No point of order. Okay, you've had your opportunity to speak. Now I'm
point of order. Point of order, Madam Chair.
I'm very disappointed. You don't sit here and discuss things over and over and over again when they've already been discussed. We need to be dealing with
point of order.
Fine.
I just wish when you had, honestly, I completely appreciate your wanting to speak. And that's why I asked before I called the vote, did anyone want to say anything? And you said no. And your card was up. And that's why I asked you.
Very well.
No, please speak. But after we conclude the vote, I can't do it.
We're here to conduct business. We're in the middle of a pandemic. And every time we come to these meetings, we've got to deal with issues that are not directly related to this pandemic. This of all issues rise to the issue to the level of serious consideration.
Point of order.
Thank you very much. We're going to move on to new business B.
Okay, fine.
Thank you. Again, speak up when I ask you to speak up before I call the vote. Please, please. I appreciate you. Discussion to ascertain commission direction on how to address the impacts of the COVID-19 pandemic as it relates to the businesses who lease facilities from the city at the beach casino and the golf course. Thank you. An item on what we're actually going through. Thank you. All right. Who